everybody. I'm Rick Beato. So it's been about 3 months since I checked in on the rock list on Spotify, the Rock This Rock List. 3 months ago, Taylor Momsen, I remember, had the top two songs on there. Glancing at this, there are some similar bands with new songs, but it looks like it's a completely new list. So we're going to count down from the top 10 and check out what's going on in modern rock right now. The number 10 song is called Amnesia by Mod Sun. Let's check it out. Okay, that's a very Smashing Pumpkins thing. I like that off the bat right there. This is actually something that I noticed when I was doing the metal list, the countdown, is that a lot of the songs didn't have the huge production value like this, where it has really, it's very well mixed, has massive bottom end, drums are really kicking them. This is very well recorded and mixed. I mean, there's only a couple chords in the song, but it's cool. There are a couple of huge sounding chords, and it's a really strong melody. I think the variation of the drum rhythms with the guitar stabs and also all the little dissonances that are going on. Very Smashing Pumpkins there. Song number 9 is by Suko and Travis Barker. It's called SOS. Let's check it out. So the auto-tune is kind of weird. Okay, you guys know I don't like auto-tune that much, but let's see what happens here. Whoa. All right, the voice is really loud in the mix, kind of gets in your face. It sounds huge, though. The mix sounds huge. They lay off the auto-tune in the chorus. In the verse, to me, it's a bit much, but, you know, this is my own personal taste. I'm not a big auto-tune person when it comes to rock. Some of the interesting things about this, the verse part... Cool thing about it is that right before it goes to the chorus, and it drops in from the 2 to the 1 in the chorus. Pretty stock chord changes in the chorus, but there's some really interesting things in it, and it sounds really big. And you definitely get points for that from me. Okay, song number 8. Is Invincible featuring Lindsey Stirling. This is Escape the Fate. Okay, hold on. Okay. That's in drop C. We got to change guitars. Okay, so now I'm in drop C tuning. Got the right guitar. Let's take it from the top. That first riff, I heard a flat 9. Yeah. Changes there. Okay. Da-da-da-da. That's interesting. Okay, let's check it out. I think I got this. Okay, it goes into a like a programmed trap beat. Kind of interesting. This, like the first two songs, sounds massive. Once again, they must be hiring good mix engineers for this. Great tom sounds. They're kind of loud, but I like it. Okay, this changes here. Yeah, and then, remember this. Here's one of the things. When you start getting into these drop songs like this, drop Cs, you tend to find a lot of the same type of chord progressions, right? A lot of these kind of things. This one is a little bit different. I think it makes it a little fresher. But, you know, these things are very common. A lot of these drone drop songs have a lot of similarity because they keep coming back to the same tonic, that low, in this case, the low C. Okay, song number 7 is by Pop Evil. It's called Breathe Again. Cool sound, lo-fi, distorted vocal. Okay. Okay, we're definitely in a lower tuning. Sounds like I have to get the 7 string out. Okay, I have my 7 string guitar here. I'm not sure if it's on a 7 or 8. Hard to tell until we listen a little more. Let's check it out. Really distorted vocal. Okay, that's a digital whammy. Done with a, like a Tom Morello, right? So let's check it out. And then I hear that low. Oh, that's a great riff. Da 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 dun da dun dun. Let me try that. I like that. See. Okay, one of the things that they're doing here in the melody is using that flat six on the third chord of the chorus. That flat six over that the third chord in here on that minor chord gives it a real melancholy vibe. Which this song sounds great. Every song has sounded great. They must be all using the same mixer or something. Okay, so song number six is by Zero. It's called Adrenaline. Let's check it out. Okay, so one of my pet peeves is the songs with no intros, so it comes right in with the guitar and the voice. I hear the breath there. Okay. Sounds like it's tuned down. Yeah, it's definitely tuned down a whole set, but I can play it on this guitar. Trap beat. Okay, that's cool that there's that break before the chorus, so it's not predictable, but those guitars, woo! Those guitars are distorted there, and I don't know if it's in a good way here. Same progression. On this chart, to me, this is really more like a rap song than a rock song. I like the verses. I like the sounds of the verses. The chorus, though, the guitars are, they have a distortion to them that's like a digital distortion that, to me, is not pleasing to the ear. It's kind of like that when I hear it. Okay, song number five is by Lilith Czar. It's called Anarchy. Let's check it out. Yeah, okay. Sounds like it's actually tuned down a step again, like the last song. Oh, okay. See if it's gonna get heavy. Okay. Okay, that's kind of cool. Sneak in the first conversion after the prayer. This has really, really great singing, interesting melody. I'm not familiar with this band. I don't know Lilith Czar. Maybe she's been around for a while, but be interested to hear more. Okay, coming in at number four is Love Race by Machine Gun Kelly and Kellen Quinn. Let's check it out. It's definitely in a lower tuning, I can tell. Okay, I'm going to drop the guitar down here. Okay, let's take it from the top. Okay. I found a silver ring. And play for the reaper. Count nice. I love active vocals. Really good syncopation. Really good syncopation right there in the line. Listen. Really good. Yeah, that's really great singing. Having that voice up the octave there is just so powerful. Just having that half step down tuning there, it's actually not a half step down, it's tuned down lower than that. I can tell the guitar is lower. But just that change in key to me is refreshing to my ear from everything that I'm hearing. Okay, coming in number three, we have Boilermaker by Royal Blood. Okay, Royal Blood is two people, and it's a bass, but I have a guitar, but it doesn't matter, because I know it's going to sound like a guitar. Sounds like a guitar! Okay, hold on, I screwed up. I think I got it. The delay. Swing. Great production. Like on the last one. Nice backwards sound. I like that. I love those kick drum patterns, like the 16th note accents after the snare to me are really cool. Even on straight rock, really like it on a swing groove like this or a shuffle. And once again, really great production stuff. This is, I've been listening to some Royal Blood since the last video that we did, and the songs and production are excellent on it. Song number two is by Weezer. It's called All the Good Ones. That's a good title. So Weezer's been writing hit songs for, oh my God, 30 years now? Has it been that long? It's been a long time. I was playing in bands when Weezer was on the charts. And they're still on the charts. Okay, coming in at number one is Kenny Hoopla and Travis Barker. Hollywood Sucks. I was just in Hollywood last week, and Hollywood's actually pretty cool. Let's check it out. Okay, I got this. That's definitely bouncing out the open D string. Listen. That's very fast, though. Okay, I got it. Here we go. Woo! Can't keep up with that. I like that melody. I like how the melody down, 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 down is triplet based against the straight groove is cool. My favorite pop punk beat, played by my favorite pop punk drummer. Cool drum beat. That is the top 10 Rock This Spotify playlist for this week. And I will say that it's very different from the last one, all different songs. This compared to the metal list was noticeably larger sounding production-wise. The last Rock This, like Taylor Momsen's track sounded phenomenal. Those are the ones that I remember. Royal Blood sounded great. These, a lot of the tracks on a production level sounded really big. So maybe they have some new people mixing these songs, but this is really, I thought it was a very cool list. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe. If you're a first-time viewer, ring the bell. That'll let you know when I go live and when a new video comes out. Give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment. That's very important. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. Follow me on Instagram at rickbeato1. Check out the new Beato Ear Training Program at beatoeartraining.com. And if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks for watching.